The hype for Star Wars Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker has officially begun, with the release of the first ever teaser trailer for the movie. And as promised, we are here to break it down and discuss everything you missed. If you want to hear my specific thoughts on Palpatine and Luke Skywalker's potential return, I will link that video in the description down below. But without further delay, let's go ahead and jump right into our breakdown. The trailer opens up with Rey on a desert planet, hearkening all the way back to where we first encountered her in The Force Awakens on Jakku. Speaking of the planet of Jakku, there were rumors all the way back when Episode 7 was released that Episode 9 would in fact return to Jakku, and that the planet would be playing another major role in the sequel trilogy. Many will talk about that Jakku was the main battle site and final stand of the Empire against the New Republic. Many will also say that this planet that Rey is on cannot be Jakku because there are no wreckage here from the Imperial battle against the New Resistance, as that battle was absolutely massive and there were destroyed ships everywhere. However, that battle did not take place solely over the entire planet of Jakku, and there were actually sections where the battle did not take place. It is a possibility that this is a location on Jakku where the battle did not actually happen, therefore why there's no wreckage. Other than that though, we're not 100% sure exactly which planet this is, we can only speculate. Again though, it was said all the way back when The Force Awakens was coming out that we did not see the end of Jakku in Star Wars. Something else to point out is the Skywalker Legacy lightsaber has been repaired. As last we saw, it was split in half by the combined power of Kylo Ren and Rey in the finale of The Last Jedi. Now though, it appears as if there's a brown bandage around the lightsaber. Something else interesting to point out is many speculated that the lightsaber, similar to Kylo Ren's now, would have an unstable nature to it. The reason Kylo Ren's cross-guarded lightsaber is unstable is because the kyber crystal within it is cracked. This led many, myself included, to speculate that Rey's lightsaber, or the Legacy lightsaber, would in fact have this crackling effect as well. We see though that when Rey activates the lightsaber and begins to run, it's back to normal, indicating that the kyber crystal within the Skywalker Legacy lightsaber is not in fact damaged. Now let's briefly talk about the voiceover by Mark Hamill, Luke Skywalker himself, as he talks about that the culmination of the Jedi Order, 1,000 generations, lie within Rey. As we know, she took the ancient Jedi texts after she departed the planet of Octo. At the Rise of Skywalker panel, J.J. Abrams as well as Daisy Ridley stated that Rey has begun the books but has not actually completed them. We also see here our first appearance of Kylo Ren, as he's in a brand new TIE fighter approaching Rey on the planet. Again, this is a brand new TIE fighter for Kylo Ren, and not the TIE silencer that he used in Star Wars The Last Jedi. It is presumed that the TIE silencer was actually destroyed on the Supremacy in Star Wars The Last Jedi, and now Kylo Ren has a brand new TIE fighter to pursue Rey. Here we also get a brand new look at some of Rey's increased abilities. JJ revealed in the panel that again, Rey has seemingly become more powerful after more time learning from the Jedi texts, and following the time jump in The Last Jedi. And here we see that the two equals in the light and dark side of the force will clash yet again in Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker. The next shot we get is what might be an A-Wing fighter approaching some sort of village built high up in the mountains. On which planet this is, I'm not really sure, as it's extremely difficult to guess in Star Wars. This could be a brand new planet that we know nothing about, or a planet that we visited before. It's immediately following this that we get to see Kylo Ren as well as the First Order stormtroopers attacking what appears to be a village, as Kylo Ren body slams someone. If you look in the background, you can see that it's highlighted by the sort of red hue color, a color extremely similar to what Starkiller Base produced all the way back in The Force Awakens. What this means, I'm not sure, but I can speculate on a limb that this could be a flashback sequence. If you look extremely closely at Kylo Ren as he body slams this individual, if you zoom up to his face, you can actually see that it appears as if he's missing his scar. This could confirm to us that it does in fact happen in the past, and that this is a flashback, far before he ever encountered Rey and their duel on Starkiller Base. But again, it could simply just be skewed and his scar could be there and we're just simply not seeing it. We saw in The Force Awakens Kylo Ren with the Knights of Ren stab someone in Rey's force back vision, and someone that was officially named by JJ to be a clan leader. Ever since The Force Awakens, many have speculated that Kylo Ren here with the Knights of Ren was not in fact taking place in the past, but was an event taking place in the future. Again, this theory is sort of out there, but we do know that the Knights of Ren will be playing a role in Star Wars Episode 9, and interestingly, we did not glimpse them in this trailer. I did take a really close look at exactly who Kylo Ren body slams though, and they do not appear to be Resistance fighters. They appear to be another group entirely. What they're after here, we're not sure, but it is interesting. After this, we get even more of Kylo Ren, as he's repairing his helmet just as was was leaked a few weeks back. In The Last Jedi, following Kylo Ren's first interaction with his master Snoke, he smashed his helmet against an elevator. Now though, he's welding it together, and Kylo Ren's helmet here and mask will sort of have a crystal lining within it, as the material that he's using is a sort of red crystal material. Something I do want to point out though, is the actual person repairing Kylo Ren's helmet is not Kylo Ren. As you can see here, their hands are extremely hairy, and they appear to be some type of alien species. You can also see that the welder is not done here, as the helmet is still split in half. But again, it's important to note that the person repairing Kylo's helmet is not Kylo Ren. After this is Finn and Poe together on what appears to be the same desert world that we see Rey and Kylo on at the beginning of the trailer. It's also important to note here that Finn is holding Rey's staff. J.J. Abrams made it clear at the panel that this was a Star Wars adventure that the whole group is going on, as he made it very clear as he repeated it several times. It seemed as if the group will not be breaking off in Star Wars Episode 9, and will be sticking together, sort of the reverse of what happened in the original trilogy, where in A New Hope the whole group is together, but they slowly break off as the trilogy progresses, again with this being the inverse of what happened there. After this is an image and a shot of BB-8 along with his new friend named Dio, a resistance droid that was introduced to us at Star Wars Celebration. We then get one of the highlights of the trailer for me personally, Lando, as well as Chewbacca, flying the Millennium Falcon through hyperspace. For those of you that saw Solo, this is Lando actually reuniting with his droid friend L3, who died in Solo but was uploaded to the Falcon, thus explaining why the dialect of the Falcon was so strange. It's absolutely phenomenal here though to get to see Billy Dee Williams back within the Falcon, and along with his old friend Chewbacca, as it's suspected as if Lando Calrissian will be playing a major role in Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker. It's also speculated that the new character, Jonna, is in fact Lando Calrissian's daughter, and it was even hinted at the Star Wars Celebration panel. We don't get to know a lot about Jonna, but I am excited to see her in Episode 9, and learn more about her and her relationship with Lando. After this, we get a shot of an action sequence again on this desert planet, with Poe and Finn, as well as C-3PO, running away from the First Order. If you look closely, this might be the first appearance of a First Order sand trooper, with one of them riding what appears to be a speeder bike and the other with a jetpack. Again, you can tell these are the First Order thanks to the very brief glimpse that we get of its white armor, as well as the green blaster fire that we get a look at here. After this, for me, are some of the most exciting shots in the entirety of the trailer, as we get a great look at an A-wing bomber that is shot down. But in the background is what's even more interesting than this. If you look closely, it actually appears to be a Republic cruiser, as you can see the red stripe down the middle of it. It is possible that the Resistance on their last leg are forced to use vessels and ships all the way back to the Clone Wars era, which I think is a really, really cool touch, getting to see all the different eras battling in the finale of the Skywalker saga, with the Republic cruiser, the A-bombers from the original trilogy, and the brand new First Order ships, and maybe new Resistance ships as well, all three eras clashing in a climactic battle. After this, we get the return of the Star Wars Medal of Bravery that we haven't seen since the original Star Wars movie. The medals that were given to Luke Skywalker and Han Solo after they helped destroy the first Death Star above Yavin. This could in fact confirm a major theory for Star Wars Episode 9, that they will in fact be returning to Yavin at some point in the movie, perhaps the Resistance reclaiming an old, ancient Rebel base. The same Rebel base on Yavin that was predominantly featured in Rogue One, as well as the original Star Wars movie. After this, we get one of the most emotional shots in all of Star Wars history, as Leia and Rey embrace one another. It was stated by J.J. Abrams at the panel that they would be using footage that they shot for Carrie Fisher in The Force Awakens to recreate her role in Episode 9, and that they would sort of center the story around those scenes that they shot so that they would make sense in The Rise of Skywalker. This could in fact be additional footage that they shot when Rey and Leia embrace at the end of The Force Awakens, and it's again altered to fit into the story of Episode 9. After this, we see the group approaching what is clearly the Death Star, which is extremely, extremely interesting, as you can see here, it looks as if it could be either of them, either the Death Star 1 or the Death Star 2. Palpatine, who laughs at the end of the Episode 9 trailer, perished on the Death Star 2. This is somewhat interesting and confusing though, as both Death Stars exploded with a lot of finality in both movies. With that said though, it's more likely that this Death Star is in fact the first Death Star, as this does not appear to be the forest moon of Endor, and it looks far more similar to the landscape of Yavin, which does feature some masses of water than it does Endor itself, leading me to speculate that these are the remnants of the first Death Star, and the aftermath of the Battle of Yavin. Of course, as I mentioned, the other possibility is this is not the first Death Star, but the second Death Star, and that it's within the second Death Star that the group, specifically Rey, encountered this larger evil that was mentioned on on the panel, this larger evil being Palpatine and his remnants within the Death Star 2. We go a little bit more in depth in my other video that was uploaded about this, but it is possible for Darksiders to sort of keep their presence around a certain area. We've actually already somewhat seen this in the sequel trilogy with Darth Vader's helmet, as it's already been pretty much confirmed that Kylo Ren is sort of speaking with the essence of Vader, and perhaps maybe not Vader himself, but the dark side remnants that remain there. And it's always a possibility that Palpatine could have actually attached himself to the Death Star 2, and that this is where Palpatine plays his most significant role in the Rise of Skywalker, and is in fact the larger threat than Kylo Ren. A Darksider Sith spirit existing somewhere after their death is something that is featured far more in Star Wars Legends than it is in Star Wars canon. As in Legends, all the time you hear about Sith Lords haunting their tombs, as well as sometimes even objects or lightsabers, something that we've discussed over and over again on the YouTube channel. Here though, it appears as if they may have brought that into Star Wars canon for the Rise of Skywalker. Again though, we discussed this a little bit more in depth in a video that I did earlier today, which I will link below if you're interested. And finally, the title card, The Rise of Skywalker. Which Skywalker though remains the big question. There are theories that Rey may even name this new order of Jedi or Force wielders the Skywalkers, and not the Jedi anymore. As in The Last Jedi, they sort of put the Jedi Order to bed. So perhaps Rey starts a new order of Force wielders simply known as Skywalkers. And this is the name of the new order led by Grandmaster Rey. But that was my official teaser breakdown for Star Wars Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below if I missed anything, and let me know what you guys are expecting as far as the return of Palpatine and any of the Skywalkers. Will Anakin be returning for Star Wars Episode 9? Or will Luke even be returning for Episode 9 in his physical form, and not as a Force ghost? Stay tuned on the YouTube channel, as we'll be bringing you every update for Star Wars Episode 9 that you need to know. Thank you guys as always so much for watching, may the Force be with you, and have a great day. Before you go, be sure to check out my other channel, The Marvelous Wave, where we talk all about the Marvel Cinematic Universe, including news, breakdowns, and theories about all upcoming and past Marvel movies. Link to the channel is in the description below.